folks. This is the Mud Man with part two of the Bonnie and Clyde Fact or Fiction series. Tonight we'll be talking about the Okabena Bank robbery. This robbery happened on May 19th, 1933, and supposedly it was Clyde, Bonnie, Buck, and Blanche. Now, on a side note, keep in mind that on May 12th, about a week before this, they supposedly robbed the Lucerne, Indiana Bank. That the bank being where witnesses supposedly said that Blanche and Bonnie did a lot of shooting, and a woman got hurt during the incident, which, you know, is a big red flag for me because, as you know, we've never really heard any instances of Bonnie actually being involved in any shooting, because it's been noted that Clyde had said that he didn't want Bonnie involved in any of the robberies, and generally she was either in the car or back at the hideout. And Blanche was noted saying that she definitely didn't want to take part in any criminal activity whatsoever. So now we'll get back onto the Okabena robbery. Now, like I said, this robbery happened on May 19th, 1933, and the Barrel Gang may not even have had anything to do with this robbery. You'll notice in these articles right here, there was a man named Tony Strain and his wife Mildred. Now, both of these people just recently got out of prison. They're both two tough, hardened criminals, rough characters. Tony and his brother Floyd and his wife, too, was going around the Midwest doing the same thing, robbing, and the police was looking for them as well. And sure enough, it was said that Tony and his wife and Floyd and his wife are the ones that actually did this robbery. Now, if you'll note in the articles, it states that Tony Strain got 80 years and Mildred Strain got 40 years, you know, for this robbery. So, you know, it's just another one of them flukes in this Bonnie and Clyde history. You know, I mean, you know as well as I do, there's so many things in this history that's just not true. A lot of things that are hidden, a lot of things have been lied about, and, you know, a lot of misinformation. And that's basically what these series of videos are about, to get down to the bottom of it and just show everybody, you know, where all the misinformation lies. Now, these people here, they were tried and convicted of this very robbery. So, you know, there you go. There you have it. I don't know what else I can tell you. This is, like I said, episode two, and I hope you enjoyed it. And until next time, this is the Mud Man, over and out.
This 9-pound hammer is a little too heavy for my size, honey, for my size. I'm going on a mountain, gonna see my baby, and I ain't coming back. Lord, I ain't coming back.